Welcome, folks, to a proper mission starting in Las Venturas. Here we are, and we're going to continue going on our quest for 100% in San Andreas. And as I'm sure we alluded to when we drove by it when we were dating Barbara, we got to go over to Wuxi's casino. This one, in practice, actually got very annoying because I kept forgetting that the spawn point is on the inside. But the other thing about this casino is that it actually functions as a save point. Which I probably should have saved at last time, all things considered. So yes, the Four Dragons Casino actually does function as a proper casino. So you got slot machines, video poker, blackjack, and you got roulette. I'll get into that later on. For now, let's just see what Woozy has in store for us.
Idiot! Do you realize how much those machines cost? We're supposed to be opening it. What the fuck was that? Hello? Hello? What the fuck is wrong with you people?
Boss, CJ's here.
Carl, glad you can make it.
So, this what you've been doing?
Yeah, it's been a complete nightmare. You want a stomach ulcer? Try opening a triad casino in a mafia-run town.
The mob trying to squeeze you?
Yeah, the corporations are moving in and everybody's feeling the squeeze. I've had slot machines busted up, workmen being scared off.
So who behind this?
Huh? Well, there are these three mob families operating here and each of them has a stake in Caligula's casino. And some whacked out lawyers running it for them. You could be any one of them. Or all of them.
Can't you just give them a little something?
No. In addition to the usual authorities that need bribing, each one would want a slice. And I'm not about to hand over all our profits to some wise guy Italians.
Our profit?
That's right, you heard me. I want to offer you a share in our casino. In exchange for some help setting it up. How's that sound, partner?
Sound like we got a deal then.
Boss, the boys found some thugs trying to smash one of the deliveries. We caught one of them.
Get rid of him.
Hey, wait, hold up, come here. Whoever's behind this, we need to let them know that they dealing with full-fledged psychos. Tie him to the front of the car, let him sweat it out a little, and I'll be out there in a little while. See if we can make this guy squeal.
That's my car.
Hey, who the fuck? Who are you? Untie me, huh?
You know what? I think we're gonna take a little drive.
What are you, fucking stupid? I'm not joking here. Untie me, motherfucker.
Nah, I think I'm gonna leave you right where you are.
You got any idea in that pea-brain head of yours who the fuck I am?
Nah, but I think I'm gonna find out.
Hey, you think you're smart, but you're not. You're not. Man, this shit don't scare me, asshole. Somebody, anybody, help!
So yeah, it's a pretty simple strategy. Just do hard turns.
Oh man, this is too fast!
You're not allowed to be on the freeway, mostly because it would just make it too easy.
Oh, slow down! Slow down, for God's sake!
Oh, shit.
What are you doing now?
Well, so insane stunts were supposed to give him, like, a crazy amount of scares.
You're gonna kill both of us. Oh, my God, I'm still alive.
But, apparently not.
Thank you. Thank God. Thank God. Mother, man, that was lucky.
Where else can I go?
Jesus!
So that was a big turn, or a big jump. Let's try some harsh turns.
Hey, wait, what you doing?
Ooh, okay, they gave us a good suggestion. Driving on the wrong side of the road. Some burnout 3 stuff.
Oh, slow down! Slow down, for God's sake! Hey, wait, what you doing?
Now let's go for a bit of a ride. Wrong side of the road?
Slow down,
oh, shit. A head-on collision is said to kill him, but he just lived right there.
God, it's too bad! Too bad! Oh, slow down, for God's This is too bad! The family will make you pay for this!
Which family?
The Zendako family, you idiot!
That's all I wanted to hear.
What? Oh, shit!
Alright, there we go. Scared the piss out of this guy, now we can return to the casino. That was a little, not a really hard mission, but the restriction of not being allowed to use the highway actually does restrict you a little bit. But once you get the idea of what you should do, it's easy to find just spots where you can speed things up, hence why I went for the insane jump really early. But unfortunately, that didn't add as much as I was hoping. And thankfully, he didn't die from the multiple minor crashes I got into. So, let's do this. So now we know the name of the family that's been messing with Wuji. Let's see what else he has lined up for us. He's gonna need some special tools for his next job that he wants us on. And let's see how he's gonna find them.
The glorious sound of a hole-in-one.
Great shot, boss.
Thanks.
Not bad, Woolsey.
So, the Zendako family was behind the attempts to sabotage our venture. I wonder why it's only them and not the others.
Probably ain't just them. Rule of the streets, don't snitch. What we need is to hit the Mafia casino. Yeah, go jack the place.
Hey, hitting a casino isn't like gangbanging. It's a whole different league.
Yeah, you right. It'll take some planning, but I'm down. She always wanted to pull a heist. What the?
Ah, bad luck. Listen, you're gonna need a crew and some special equipment.
Yeah, it'll take some explosives. Always gotta blow up shit to pull a heist.
You know what? There's an open cast mine southwest of the city limits. They must have explosives.
I'll go peep it out.
So yeah, we gotta get some explosives to enter or break and enter into some casino vaults. Once you finish with this mission, Wuji's missions will now be split in two. One of them will actually be specifically focused on exclusively working on the plan to jack the casino, or to do a large-scale robbery. The other one, I think, I can't remember what the hell its other objective was. And right here is where the casino is, and I keep forgetting because it's not really marked. I guess they don't want people turning into this place from the highway. Okay. Now we enter the quarry. Oh wait, no, I forgot. You just go down, so you don't really need anything special. Enter the quarry and steal the dynamite. The dynamite is rigged to blow. Unfortunately, we got there too late, so now we got to get it before the workers destroy it. You'll need something heavy to smash these crates. Get the dynamite before the timer runs out and before it's detonated. They're all on the lower floor, and all the heavy equipment is already down there. So,
who's this asshole?
You might think the best strategy is to smash, get out, and grab, but to my knowledge, the best strategy is smash all of them and then grab them all.
Hey, you can't come down here!
I do what I want. Unfortunately, with this,
stay away from that stuff!
With the way this works,
what do you think you're doing?
The camera controls are allocated to controlling the bed, So, you cannot control the camera at all. Somehow I blew up a forklift without blowing it up. And something I didn't notice about this until I actually got into practice, you can actually grab the dynamite in a dirt bike. It looks like the way they program this is that it just checks for Carl's hitbox. So yeah, this is the—
Someone call security!
This is the quick and easy way to get all the dynamite. Four sticks out of four. Get back home with the dynamite. Security is blocking the exits. Use the dirt bike to find another way out. So yes, this is a, this is a platforming level using sandbox controls and a motorcycle. Unfortunately, I get why they kind of like, they kind of signpost you this hard. I thought it would have been cool if you had full control and it's like, find your own way out. And run over this guy so that you don't have to deal with him with getting shot all the time. And you can figure out this path over here. Take that side wind. Get rid of— oh wow! For once, people don't dive away— don't dive into my car, they dive away from it. What a concept! Wow, that was close. Okay. You might think there's another way up there, but unfortunately no. So you gotta take this path. And that's some shitty security right there. Get on the top layer and deliver the dynamite to the drop-off point. And now that's not gonna be the last time we enter the quarry, as we're actually going to be going back there after this mission to do some side missions. But for now, let's continue with Woozy.
Delivery for Woozy. Hey, you be careful with that.
Oh my god. He fucking bumped his car into a tree immediately after getting the dynamite. You be careful with that. Small collision immediately. But yeah, as I mentioned before, now Wuxi's mission split in two. One is the green dollar sign representing the bank, the casino heist, and the other is the dragon symbol, which is to indicate the, I don't know, Wuxi specific missions? I guess the bank one is more like the casino and the dragon is more woozy? Whatever. So yeah, back to Woozy and let's see if we can meet him. Or see what he has to say.
Hit me.
Are you sure, man?
Yeah, I'm going for a 5-card hand. Come on.
Okay. Here. I'm a stick. What you got?
How would I know? You tell me.
Not good, man. You got, 47.
Damn. You're bad luck for me, you know? When I play the other guys, I always win.
Boss, take a look at these two chips.
One's a fake.
That's amazing. You didn't even touch him.
Nah, I just took a guess. Why else would he come in with two chips and sound so worried? You take a look.
Oh yeah, the dragon on this got the sunglasses and a white stick.
Insolent bastards!
I'll make sure the cashiers are extra vigilant.
It's obvious where these chips are coming from. The Sindaco family owns a plastics factory across town. I'm gonna blow it to shit!
Man, look, don't trip. I got you on this.
So yeah, head head towards the factory unit on the outskirts of town. You're going to disturb their operation. Okay, so yeah, we just go across town like this. And I don't actually remember the route. Fuck. Oh. I think I may be taking the wrong route. Whatever. Oh, no! Worked out! Going almost straight there. Oh boy. We're good. These mobsters have some guards watching the main goods entrance. Try to get into the factory unnoticed. The easiest way is just the the friggin' bus stop. And a neat thing about here, get your own weapon. Chainsaw. But that being said, the chainsaw is largely impractical.
Hey, who's this prick? Somebody take care of this joker.
I like to think of myself as a king, thank you. Hang on, I wanna grind up my other weapons, so I'm gonna use the M4, which I never use in any other mission. Even though I collected a lot of it from Area 69. So why was that guy on top of the scaffold of boxes? It doesn't seem sensible. What did he just say? Okay. Anybody else hiding up here? I don't want to be surprised. Whatever. Now we can just grind up the M4 by shooting the ever-loving crap out of these things. And yep, immediately we gain skill, and now we're already better at aiming? Oh, the lock-on range is improved. Okay. I always wondered that with some of these weapons. Did I get two of them? What? Oh, Jesus! These guys teleported. The fucking cheaters. In practice, I actually lost a lot of health and armor from this. Thankfully, I'm surviving much better than before. Upgraded. Keep practicing, you'll still be in Hitman levels. Maybe I should shave my head if I'm gonna do that. Great work, job done. Get back to Wuji's casino in one piece. What the fuck? Why did you drive your car indoors? Come on. It's just not good strategy. I'm gonna so I was planning on entering a restaurant to get rid to stay out of common sight. And also because in a couple of these next missions I'm gonna be away from food sources for a while. Oh shit. Well, so much for staying out of public light. But yeah, there we go. That's the mission. Now all we have to do is not get busted by the police. Why they go to this much effort is unnecessary. We've already taken care of what was bothering Wuji, the counterfeit chip production line. We're not really taking anything to him, and in fact, we're not even going inside. But I'm not sure why this last part is really all that necessary. I think all we do is just go up to someone and say, yeah, this isn't going to be an issue no more.
Hey, Carl, how'd it go?
tell Woozy we'll be getting no more trouble with them counterfeit chips.
That was a little bizarre. You could kind of hear a stumble in him. Now, I think that might have been very likely the ultimate goal of the mission changing. Very probably something like, we won't have any problems with these gangsters. We won't have any problems with these debt collectors. Okay. Kind of a sad thing about the Four Dragons Casino is that I went in there and I saw a restaurant and I was like, oh, okay, so like an actual casino, you would have a place you could eat indoors. But nope, you can't order food there, so I have to go north to get any food. Otherwise, I'm going to get hungry during this next mission. Oh, if only I organized this a little bit differently. I could have been able to do a side quest here, but I think I have that in the next one. Because the theme for the side quests of this part is going to be heavy machinery. We're going to be going all the way back to the quarry and doing the 8 missions that are available there. After that, we're gonna do a mission which we've had available to us for a while, but we've just not done. And that is the trucking missions. So, let's head back to the quarry and get started on that. Now, these missions are a lot more diverse than you would expect. The first two are pretty much exactly what you'd expect from a quarry mission. The other ones get kind of out there. They're also, unfortunately, very punishing when it comes to the results of failure. Because a lot of these will result in death on failure. Because of this, half the time you fail them, you will, you will simply be teleported into Las Venturas. It's quite a way to go back to here. And this mission just involves us taking rocks and taking them out of the way. Sadly, with a lot of these, they don't really tell you why you're taking them away. So, like, kind of the ultimate satisfaction of seeing things come together perfectly doesn't happen. However, one of these does. One of these is, like, move things away from train tracks and then... A train actually goes right by after you do so. It's really cool. Okay. Now I want to go in a relatively straight path, so I'm going to stay on here and clear the rocks from this level. Unfortunately, when you try to have a straight path, unless you have a straight path next to your next straight path, kind of limited on what you can do. Which is a very elaborate way of saying, I have to go backwards, even though I was trying to gain forward momentum. But yeah, driving a bulldozer is a bit trickier than you would expect, because what I didn't realize for a while here was actually that the bulldozer is rear-wheel drive. So, dear. So because of this, going forward, you actually have an extremely, turning circle. But going backwards, you actually have a very wide turning circle, so it's like the opposite of a normal car. Especially because a normal car, or actually no, it's even smaller than a normal car would be, because a normal car, fuck. Yeah, I think I messed this up. Yeah. No, I forgot that every time you do a successful delivery, you actually gain time. I probably did the really, like, out there elaborate ass route to do this. There we go. Oh shit, no, I didn't gain time. Fuck. Crap. Oh, that's why. It's because there's a freaking natural route to this and ah, damn it, I skidded out. Ah! Damn it. Delivery trucks have arrived. Oh my god, yeah, there's a natural route from the down up. So this is definitely something you do on the way back rather than the way forward. Shoot, so already I failed the first mission by being a dumbass and not and being suboptimal. As is my lot in life. Alright, let's get started again. Use the bulldozer to clear paths before the next delivery arrives. Which is weird, you'd think they would arrive and then they would, and then you would actually see them coming forward and... Oh, shit. Safe. But it's weird, you'd think you would see them arrive and then go through the path. But I guess they didn't want you to wait on everything. And not everything is as fast as a train. Okay, and... Oh, there is a natural path to this. You go all the way over here, you push this one off the edge, and then it circles back around. So there is an optimal routing. Optimal routing. It's just that with no wall markers on the map, it's hard to tell. Oh, shit. Okay. There we go. So now we're going to be a lot more comfy. Alrighty then. Now we're back on the lower levels, or actually no, we finally come back to the lower levels. And there's one that's on a, okay, yeah, there's one right across the ridge, and then one on the way back up. Also, my microphone settings may be a little bit different because I accidentally uninstalled Audacity, thinking that I was uninstalling an older version. Because I noticed that my hard drive was ridiculously full. And later I realized, oh shit, it's because I accidentally installed a Steam game in a directory that I wasn't supposed to. And we should be good. You've completed your first quarry mission. Return to the side office for more. And naturally, a cool thing about having an optimal route is you aren't that far away from starting the next mission. So let's start on that. Bonds have been planted by a rival organization. Use the bulldozer to do something. Oh shit, I forgot the first one is outside. So yeah, they kind of trip you up immediately. Alright, and this is the one that I believe you gain time every time you put an explosive in a safe area. And immediately they kind of put you in a position where you're kind of fucked over. Because your car was actually too, or the bomb was too close to the house to be able to just take care of slowly. Why did it explode twice? So yeah, what happens here is that these explosives are in potentially dangerous circumstances. So you gotta push them to less than dangerous circumstances. And some of these do make sense. For example, that last one was in a... Oh, no, 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 no! Oh. Oh. Okay, I didn't know that that had backups. I thought I was just gonna have to fail. That's neat, actually. Maybe that's actually the smart strategy to get closer to the other ones. Ah, shit. God damn it. Fuck. No, don't explode. Ah, Jesus. No, it has too much momentum. Fucking hell. I can't get it to slow down in my... And the friggin' thing is too wide. Damn it! Stop moving to the right, you son of a bitch. God damn, it's not going in the center. Okay, there we go. Come on. Come on! Damn it. Alright. There we go. Woo! Ah, yes, and that's the idea with a lot of these, is that they are at, the explosives are at areas of strategic destruction. And what the fuck? Oh, that's why the ridge caused it to fucking fall out of the plow. Okay. Whew. Oh, wow, okay. So I thought that some of these were put in, like, senseless positions. But no, they actually do have reason. They're trying to destroy the equipment because they're a rival company. So, funnily enough, it's like, while this mission is kind of janky, it does kind of work as almost an anti-version of some of the quests you'd see in Vice City. Of stuff like, oh yeah, if you want to destroy a rival company... is that you would set this up. Okay, so they hire somebody like Carl to clean it up for you. Get him coming and get him going. Alright. So I managed to... brute force my way through that just by forcing it against a wall and then just pushing it forward. But there is no fucking way I'm driving that all the way back up, so I'm taking the dirt bike. And back at the front of the quarry, we're on mission 3. I believe this is either 6 or 8 missions. 8, if I'm not mistaken, is the actual number. Is this the first one where we go outside? Yes, it is. The bombers are escaping in a dumper. Use this dumper to destroy it before they reach safety. So they are right there. And the more direct route over, and it took me a while to realize this, is just to the left. This is not, as I previously thought... an extension of the quarry, but it's just a route into the quarry. It's like the official way you're supposed to get in. And following this up, you can gain a lot of momentum just by following them in a straight path. But of course, we're both in the same car. So there's only so fast we can go, and I can't use my camera to get a better vantage point because it just moves the fucking bed. The part where you want to be very careful is on an oncoming bridge. Once you're out of the bridge, you are very, very at risk. Oh, whoa. So that does not have the same endurance as the car as the one we have. So if you just shoot it, it just blows up easy. But yeah, if you get it to that bridge, it's super, super sketchy to try to push the other dumper off the edge, because you are so likely to fall off into the ocean. Or the river, sorry. Now, this dumper has a lot of unique properties to itself. It has similar properties to a tank, where it accumulates so much damage all at once that a lot of cars will just blow up if you run it over. And also, like the tank, it's surprisingly easy to flip it over if you just get under the exact wrong kind of car. But anyway, we're right by the, Oh god, it's chasing us! But yeah, we're right by the quarry, so let's start into our next quarry mission. Bombers have been caught. Their bodies loaded in a dumpster on the other side, on the quarry's other entrance. Dump them before the cops come snooping. Now, this mission is deceptively hard, because you'd think, I was like, okay, pretty simple ideas. Here's the thing they don't tell you. The bodies are in the bed. If you move this bed for any reason, the bodies come loose and then they kind of have this weird inertialess physics about them where they sort of will just float. But here's the thing, that happens even if you are in like the mildest of mild collisions. So you pretty much have to go through this without hitting your... I don't know how that didn't activate it. Without hitting your truck on anything. And here's the one that really messed me up. You have to do this without hitting your handbrake too hard, or braking too hard, or turning too hard. Otherwise, your load will just fly out, and you're dead. And you have to, restart the mission. You're not dead. So all this time, I'm not accelerating. I'm just using the momentum I get off some of these hills. I braked right there, but not too harsh. Slow down. So you cannot drift. You cannot suddenly stop. You can't do anything that quick. And of course, you can't get into any kind of a harsh collision. Ah, Jesus. Had these bodies been loosened at all, they would have just been dead right there. Or sorry, the mission just would have failed. Also, if you want to stay still while you dump your load, hold the handbrake and then do it. Whew, there we go. 4 quarry missions finished. This is like a very weird story we just witnessed. It's like low-level sabotage to escalated sabotage. Then we deal with the people who inflicted the sabotage. Now we gotta get away with inflicting the people who inflicted the sabotage. And now we gotta take extra steps to make sure that nobody discovers what's going on. It's kind of a cool story within a story. If that makes any sense. The dumper is loaded with explosives and needs to be driven gently. Deliver the explosives to the desert airstrip. Kind of a neat thing about this is that it's kind of an implication about what we're gonna do the rival construction company after they attempted to sabotage. Okay, I'm surprised that did not kill us, because when they said this is a gentle explosive, they're not lying. If you do any kind of side collision, front collision of any kind, this just blows up. Because of this, I'm sticking to the road, and I am obeying the freaking speed limit. Somewhat. Oh, shit! Okay. Now, where is the route there? Now, you may be wondering why I'm taking this route instead of the one to the right, to the airstrip. The reason is that the one to the right will take us to above the airstrip. Trying to get to the airstrip from the upper level is actually very tricky without running into a lot of rocks. On the lower level, on the other hand, it's actually very simple. Is this the way there? Yes. Thankfully, this game has a somewhat forgiving notion of what a collision is. Also, like the other... Oh my god, are you kidding me? Like the other mission, this has a... God! So... Like I said before, any collision will cause an explosion. That includes a collision with a vehicle, even if it has a ramp. Because of that, we're starting over again, boys. It just goes to show, the worst thing that a heavy vehicle can come across is another heavy vehicle. God damn it. Okay. Yeah, we're back to driving gently. And as I'm sure I skipped forward a bit after that explosion, but yeah, I did have to drive all the way from the hospital by the airport to the- What the fuck?! I'm fucking bailing. I don't give a shit. Now that those explosives are loose, they'll just fucking fly out for anything. I braked slightly too hard, and because of that, they just fucking came loose. So that's what I meant by you can't really use your handbrake that much with this. You have to try to slow down using the reverse button, which on my controller would be square for PlayStation and X for Xbox. Well, at least that one we didn't have to go all the way from the airport. Just from up this hill. And of course, do not press that right analog stick. So there is a lot of leeway when it comes to time. Because you can actually make it there pretty consistently fast. Every time I see planes, they freak me out. Because I'm thinking they're going to crash into me and kill me. It is not recommended to off-road it at all, for obvious reasons. Holy shit, I thought I was about to freaking hit that sign. And I got super fucking nervous. Wait, is there even a taxi in front? No, there isn't. Wait. Okay, no, I cannot do that route. Because that one goes through canyons and the barrels are definitely going to come loose and fucking fly all over the place. That's not the turn. Oh my god, what the fuck? That truck just fucked me over. Oh my god, are you fucking kidding me? That son of a bitch. It's missions like this that remind you why... games eventually stop trying to have alternate uses for the analog sticks when they already use them for camera controls. So this mission is not as hard as it initially seems, but it doesn't seem as hard as it initially seems, but it is probably the hardest of all the missions. Oh my god, but it's prone to a lot of random flaws just because of the way the game is programmed. Like, the game is programmed to have a certain amount of random events, like crashes on freeways. If you come across that, you can easily be screwed if you aren't in a good position to bypass it. Alright, I gotta hope I don't bump. Holy Jesus. Yeah! Okay. Alright. Okay, nobody on the right side. Alright, on the left side, sorry. Okay. Oh shit, there's a car behind me, so I don't know how much I can slow down. Uh-oh. That's a tight fit. Alright. Whew. Oh my god, this is nervous. Nerve-wracking. I gotta try to bypass this van. I have to hope that nobody comes on the other side. Thankfully no one is. At least for a little bit. Alright, oh no! Oh, Jesus! Oh my god. Don't take this route because you come across a lot of trees and some hidden rocks, and that can be super fucking dangerous. You're gonna want to stay along the street for a little bit. Although, oh my god, I can't believe that worked out. Jesus. Like I said, a certain amount of programmed randomness. And either way, it's on the west end of the... Oh, Jesus, come on! Hurry up, fucking hell. Oh, no! What? Did you spot that fucking car? Holy shit. Drop the barrels, the soft sand will prevent an explosion. I don't think that's how it works, but whatever. Also, yeah, last time I did this, it also gave me an absurd amount of, triple score for a stunt that I never did. But holy shit, that quadruple fucking backflip by that car that got under my tire serves him fucking right for thinking that he should get in the way of a freaking giant truck carrying explosives. Funny I say that though, because recently I actually got into an accident where like a big truck that didn't see me scraped me along the side. Didn't get hurt at all, but it was really frustrating, and it made my caused my car to get like really fucked up on one side. Like seeing with missions like that, I'm just like, god damn it, I'm in a hurry. Like, maybe that's how the truck drivers always feel. All right, so back to the quarry. What is the sixth mystery? What the fuck? A dumper has spilled its load of explosives along the train tracks. Clear them before the next train passes. Okay, and so this is not the final one. So I know this is definitely an eight mission side quest. I got confused because I'm also doing another 8-mission side quest in addition to this one. So yeah, this mission is actually very easy if you just follow one very basic strategy. It's just getting there is really tricky. Because of course the bulldozer is not well known for its off-terrain capabilities. Or maybe it is. It kind of is, I guess. I guess it's more for its off the road. It's off the all-terrain speed, I should say. So yeah, the basic strategy is actually just to push straight, and then eventually some of these are either going to fall out with a lot of momentum, or you're going to get into the next one. So you just keep doing this, and eventually they'll just fall out. You don't have to go that far. And unlike these other ones where you would have to go at a harsh angle to get these out off the railroad, you just keep going forward. So you don't have to stop. You don't have to potentially spin out. Just keep going. And just push these off the edge. What the fuck? There we go. Oh my god, come on, that's off. A train is approaching. Oh shoot. Just gotta make sure that none of the other things are doing it alright. Oh my god! What? So the train went fine, but it appears that it tried to fucking horrifically mutilate a truck driver on the way over there. Oh my goodness. I was actually planning on like getting my bulldozer on the track and just seeing it spin out just like that truck did, but I didn't get into the position in time. I did that by accident. When I misread the thing, I was like, okay, now the train will fly safely. Or sorry, now the train will go safely.
Look where you go.
And once I saw that, I was like, okay, whatever, I'll just take the tracks back. And then my fucking bulldozer spun and flew. It was amazing. Also, by the by, on the last mission, the reason I know that off-roading it is a dangerous idea is because I tried that. And inexplicably, a plane landed and was blocking one of the off-road paths. As if to say, don't try this, brother. Alright, so now we're on mission 7. This is the second to last one. A cop has been killed. Use the bulldozer in the quarry to get rid of the body before more cops come snooping. Alright. So, if I'm not mistaken, what you do is you move the body and the bike in towards the crane pickup area. So apparently, somebody came investigating, and they needed to be quieted permanently. Alright. God damn, what the fuck? That was at a right angle. How do you gain right angle tangential? What the fuck? Oh my god. What is with this? It's like there's counter gravity going on here. Come on. So this is a multi-stage mission. Do this. You get the body and you both put them onto the crane pickup area. You pick up the bodies into a dump truck. And then you take... Also, by the way, check this out. You fucking roll their bodies as if they're just like a cylinder of like aluminum or something. Oh my god. What is with the physics? They're fucking up. What's going on here? Oh, what happened? Oh my god! He got underneath the fucking car. Whatever, he's good. Alright, I'm getting out of this. Get into the crane and then put them onto a dump truck, which is conveniently nearby. I kind of like these multi-stage missions, it's just they don't tell you that it's a multi-stage mission. There we go. Onto the crane. Enter it. And it follows the exact same controls as, the other one, except slightly jankier. Actually, it took me a while to realize that the way this works is that it's away from the, is that it's away from the crane and spinning, and that's it. Oh my god, he looks like a fucking chess piece. Wait, did I grab him by his head? What the fuck? These controls are weird. Oh no, it's because I, okay, that worked. Because I forgot, I was like, wait, why is going forward lowering it? And then I realized how exactly a crane moves its objects forward, and then I realized, oh, that's why. Because I'm stupid. Okay. The items I need. And inexplicably, these, like the other ones, these just kind of lock in. Get into the dumper. Oh, no! Drive carefully to the quarry entrance. Yeah, I probably shouldn't have braked there. Thankfully, everything's okay. They're not quite fully magnetized to the bottom, but, they're a little, less, floaty than other ones have been. Dump the body and the bike in the water. It's only across the street. You know, across the freeway. Ah, Jesus, okay. And they want us to hold on to the dump truck. Okay, so I think this should be good enough. Wait, am I at an angle? There we go. We're good. Oh, the quarry is just 7 missions. I didn't realize that. Asset acquired. Got 10 grand. So we covered all their business, and as hush up money, we get 2 grand every day. Man, this project must be worth a fortune. They even give us our base time for all the quarry missions, being 20 minutes. I think mine when I first did this was 34 minutes. So yeah. After that very difficult mission, we're actually gonna go head off into another one. Might think it's a little too much. But if I thought about what was too much for me to handle, I wouldn't have accepted going into this. Alright, right back into... Alright, just before we head off into the trucking missions, that's another set of missions that takes a very long time to do. So, we're gonna need some food before that. Which you always actually want to do this before any kind of long side quest. Because it's... Otherwise, your guy's gonna start... bleeding health. Okay, now it's been a while since we've had these, but we can do the trucking missions. 4 were unlocked when we first got them from Catalina, and then 4 were unlocked once we unlocked Las Venturas. So let's get going. Now, to my knowledge, these are somewhat random. The exact model of car you get is random, and the exact location is random, but the general area is always the same, and the prompt is usually the same. So here we start off with an actual trucking mission. Can I do the, oh yeah, I can do the truck simulator, first person camera, and check out that officer showing off his style. Holy crap, he is gonna get such an insane bonus for for doing that much of a two-wheelie. Check out that. Even does the turn. Oh my goodness. So yes, now our trucking days are going well. And thankfully they actually gave us the... What the fuck? Oh, shit. Yeah, that can happen, and hence why you want a third-person camera. And there's also where we go. Somehow, we haven't lost any money. We have a delivery schedule of 16:15. That's the time, by the way, not the amount of seconds or hours left. You've completed your first trucking mission. Return to the depot at any point. There are 8 missions total, as I previously mentioned. One of these missions is kind of, is Oh no, like three of these missions are potentially infuriating, but there's one where I remember reading the 100% guide and thinking to myself, is it really this hard? It is hard, it's just that it's not, I just don't think it's as brutally hard as the way it's written to be. Or maybe, who knows, maybe that's another thing they patched in. Back to trucking. Goods must be delivered without damage to Montgomery, San Andreas. This is a fragile load. Deliver the goods intact or lose cash for damages. Yeah, ah, fucking hell. Of course, immediately I do a wide-ass turn. Oh, shoot, where is this? So this is Bone County, so do I take the first right, or... I guess I'll keep going straight and then just take the longer route, about route. This corner right here will screw you over if you have people hunting you, but otherwise it's fairly safe. And yes, that note of what is dangerous and what isn't will come into play soon enough. Oh boy. Oh yeah, with a directory this, about ultimately the safety, you're gonna want to go with the stable and consistent route, which is just around the perimeter of Los Santos. Oh, fuck! I forgot there was a stone wall here. Jesus. Trying to improvise off there, because I think before in practice I actually just went to the corner, but there I was like, I might as well try this cool thing, and it's like, no, it's not cool to crash. You just look like a fucking dipshit. Although, I think the cargo is probably fine, it's just the truck is heavily damaged. Maybe that's where the cash is going into, repairing the truck that I had just messed up. What the fuck was going on there? Something weird happened there. It must be like some weird torsion going on here. Trucks get really weird physics. It's one of the only times you'll see twisting being a really weird source of damage. Just because of the inherent nature of a hitched vehicle, or of a hitched vehicle part. Okay, now I believe these next two mostly have you driving to relatively safe areas. I believe this first one... Oh, okay, never mind about being safe. You drive to the middle of Los Santos, and then the next one is like Bone County or something. Although I don't... wait, what? So this is actually kind of a bizarre choice in the truck. The side says Zip, which is a clothing company. However, there are also vents on top, which are usually an indication of animals. What a clothing company is using animals for, I'm not sure. I'm not really sure I want to know. Although I think animal, like, storage, they also have you doing, you also need vents on the side, but I don't know if they want to... check if they really want people to be able to see them. At least that's my... what I noticed with... What the fuck? What the hell did I hit? Oh, no. Jesus Christ. That ultra cop could have fucked me up. Okay, so I just have to get this over here, but my truck is already kind of messed up. Jeez, isn't this supposed to be the easy version of this mission? You may not know, but this happens to every man at least twice a day. If you don't hit my rod again. Oh shit. Okay. Save. You got to take him to the dock area. Oh, what the fuck? Spells trouble. Let's face it.
can't believe you hit me.
Oh, shit. Okay, now I gotta speed up. I'm doing very badly at the moment. I'm surprised how few roadblocks I've seen like that. Wait. Oh, shit. I did not realize my car was that fucked up. Hang on. Oh, come on, really? Come on, I know there's like a motorcycle around here. Fuck! No motorcycle. Shit. Oh my god. Of course you got aggressive drivers surrounded by police officers. Oh well, let's go back to the truck stop and get this done. Alright, back out here. No use in- Oh! Jesus, that could have killed me. So yeah, no use in removing the wanted level because we're gonna get it right back anyway. Uh-oh. Please don't bust me. Okay, so now we've got a fuel tanker. Okay, got to hold on to this. For as long as we can. Jesus. So yeah, these missions are... Well, it depends on who you're talking to, but it's like... Some people really know them for, just absolute frustration. Others are a bit... uneasy about them. From what I understand, there is a bit of a, I was gonna say a flex, but it's a tech where you can... Where once the mission starts, just, if you don't have the car you like, just shoot the gas tank, which is always on the left side. Oh, shit. Yeah, it's always on the left side. So, you can just shoot that immediately, and then restart the mission immediately. Oh dear. Let me think. Where is this one actually? Because I forgot where it is. It's the... Okay, I'm on a relatively straight path to it. No, this one has like a fence. No, this has a wall right here, so I can't go there. So I have to go straight through the streets. Thankfully, ballers don't seem to give a shit. Alright, yep, got a good route. So this is pretty much routing is the main issue here. But then again, like, as I'm sure you saw, if you aren't smart enough about how you handle the police, you can get completely fucked over. Some of them apparently were being very aggressive about trying to come after me. And now we got a long way back to get to the truck stop. Back to trucking mission number 4, and this one I remember being a really easy one. It's just Angel Pine? Whetstone? Wait, where in Whetstone? Oh, shoot. Oh, hey, and this one's even easier because it's a shorter distance. It's really nice. And from all the experience I have with, dating Barbara, I happen to know that there is a way onto the freeway from across her farm. And man, looking at a truck that has something hitched going fucking off-road like this, it's just fucking weird. It's like it's made of jelly or something. What? Torsion! Oh no. Fuck! Oh my god, and it's still going. Usually that only happens with, like, harsh turns. Like this, I would expect to detach it, but apparently not. Jesus, okay. Deliver by 10:15. Yeah, this is easy. Like, worst thing that can happen is coming across multiple aggressive drivers, and then they all just try to hunt me down. Oh my god. And the other thing is multiple slow drivers. Because trucks need roadblocks, apparently. No, I take the whole road. The road belongs to this truck. Nobody passes me. Nobody tries to go faster than me. I need to get there on time. So yeah, I'm assuming whatever their area is, it's past this bridge. And then it's at this 11-7, I believe. And that sounds like me just, like, taking a piss out of a 7-Eleven. No, I think that's actually is what it's called. Let me pass. Four trucking missions complete. We're halfway there. Welcome. What the fuck? I could have sworn there's, like, a sign out here that says, like, 11-7s. Alright, back at the truck stop. We're now on to the second half of the truck missions. Extremely fragile goods to Easter Bay port in San Fierro. Now this mission, if I remember correctly, is... Okay, well all the ones to San Fierro I would describe like this. Not as hard as you would expect, but really frustrating to actually navigate. It's kind of the same problem that I encountered previously, where trying to make a route, or sorry, with Barbara, where if I tried to make a route, or sorry, not Barbara, Helena, that had I tried to make a route to the gym in San Fierro, I would have had to go through this area, and yeah, it is really, really elaborate. There are very few straightaways, very difficult to maintain momentum, and there's so much more risk of your car getting destroyed. Is that a fucking tractor on the... Oh my god. Alright, so we're past two tractors on the fucking highway. And then the one random car, which I think is actually needed for, what's it called? The import-export garage. Oh, Jesus, that could have been bad. Big damage, unfortunately. Thanks, homie. Oh, fuck! God damn it. Damn it, I somehow scraped against the entire wall while also... Uh-oh. Fuck. I somehow scraped the entire wall while my cargo also got hooked onto another car. I almost killed both myself and failed the mission. But thankfully this one is actually kind of close, just being the airport. Before it was way into San Fierro. Okay, and there we go. Barely any mission for how dangerous that is. Sorry, barely any money for how dangerous of a mission that is. But that's our first trek into San Fierro. And so yeah, let's go on to the next one, which I don't think this is the hardest one, but it's like the hardest one that heads into San Fierro. All right. Let's get to the trucking mission. What? This should be, yeah, illegal goods to Easter Basin, and apparently I have just maximized my muscle and didn't even try. These goods are hot and will attract police attention. Wait, that does not look right on the map. Where is it? Oh, same location. Okay. That's fine. But, wow, this is a mission that will frustrate the hell out of you if you don't know what you're doing. Whatever you do, do not go uphill. Well, don't go uphill when you can, because then you are completely open to helicopter fire, and you will just straight up fail because they will eviscerate your truck before you even get a chance to keep going. Try to stay away from any ranchers because they will push you off the road, and they are very good about doing that. Oh shit. Oh my god, they Austin powered me. Okay, there we go. And Jesus, they're spawning in way higher numbers than they did in practice. Alright. What company is hiring us for this? Oh, we don't know. Alright. Let's see. Thankfully at the moment they're just giving us a gentle boost. And gotta hope that I don't just freaking jump into the river now. Okay, good. This is the dangerous part. Right here, if they push us from the left side, we could be completely fucked over. Oh my god. Fucking trucks! Oh shit, okay, now I'm in a little bit more troublesome position. God damn it. Fuck, they're giving steady damage. This is not good. Okay, good. He's a dumbass and fell into the pole. Ah, oh, I did it on purpose! Why did I mispronounce it like that?
Fuck you, man.
Okay. I think I may be good. This tunnel does have weird properties, though, as I'm sure you noticed when I detached my truck. Let's see if that happens again. Thankfully, no. There's a cop intentionally causing traffic to be freaking roadblocking me. That son of a bitch. Whatever. Thankfully, I got the really easy path, and that was a really turn that truck just made. It was super robotic. And I made it! Woo! So the next two missions are, again, still harder. God, why did they go for that one? Are still harder than the others, but I think only one of them is, like, brutal, brutal tricky. Yeah, this route back is so much easier. It's just not viable because how slow trucks go and how much fucking... how, bottleneck they would get. Anyway... that was a cool sound effect. But let's just go and start going back to the trucking missions. Goods must be quickly delivered without damage to Green Palms, North San Andreas. Where the fuck is Green Palms? Is that the golf course? No, it's Area 69. Okay. So this is the second to last mission, but it's not as hard as either the mission before it or after it. The one after it is, I think, the hardest trucking mission. And the one before it, as I'm sure you could see, could get really fucking crazy. All you have to do here is just try not to take any damage. Oh my god, that... the fucking end got a huge amount of momentum. Pretty straightforward. But I think it's like once we get onto Las Venturas that things get a little weird. Yeah, it kind of kills that the momentum that I have to keep checking the map every so often just to make sure I'm on the right path. I can see why they eventually added the GPS. Although I think it kind of kills the fun of making your own path. What the fuck happened there? Why? Can somebody tell me why the hell it just detached? It just started fucking spazzing out. Was it because I decided to off-road it? I've been through much harder off-road areas. Whatever. Go into this petroleum, processing area. And there we go. 7 trucking missions complete. Got one more to go, but oh boy, is it a doozy. Alright. Now we're back here for the final trucking mission. Oh boy! You're about to see some shit. highly illegal goods to Spiny Bed Las Venturas. These goods are very hot and will attract a lot of police attention. 4 stars as opposed to 3. Spiny Bed Las Venturas should be way on the right side. No, it isn't. It is up north. Oh, fuck. Oh, my God. Wow. Oh, crap. That makes this way worse. Oh, shit. Okay. Strategizing time. Because you got to figure this stuff out before you get to certain points. So, the route I take is go up to this corner, go to the right, and then figure out some way to get up from there. The reason is because on the south side of Las Venturas, there are multiple areas where the police can very, very easily push you off into the river. And they seem to have freaking specialized in doing that because, oh my god, they are so successful at it. Thankfully, the cargo appears to be quite heavy, so them even just scraping along the side of my car causes them to fly. Take right here. What the fuck was that? The bounce that my freaking cargo did. Maybe this just means I don't understand the physics of cars. Oh my god! So you saw right there what he just did. The side swipe into the hard push. Yeah, that's pretty much what they all like to do around the river. And they all go for it. So I'm avoiding being close to a body of water at all costs. This is the most dangerous part. Because, as I mentioned before, if you go too slow, you're vulnerable to helicopter fire. And thankfully, he didn't fire. He didn't fire in practice either, but I'd never take these things at the chance. And a cool little bit of manipulation you can do is, police cars like to stay in, to the left or right of you, or to a relative, by an offset of some sort. So you can take advantage of that by just, like, moving to the right in order to trap them in next to, like, a wall or, like, a sign or something. Oh, shit. Wait, can I save this? Yes, didn't detach. But, yeah, those SWAT cars, they almost screwed me over. Alright. And route straight into Las Venturas. I had an easy time before because I was on south... east of Las Venturas is where my ultimate target was. Now I'm on north central Las Venturas City. So... I gotta figure stuff out. Oh my god! Ha! Oh my god, it's always... like, seeing the cars accidentally clash together, it's just like, oh, it's all going to plan. Okay. Thankfully, I'm alright. No police cars are messing with me. Some motorcyclists could go fuck themselves. And... oh, yes. All according to plan. Oh, my God. Okay. Now that I'm somewhat close, I do need to figure out something. A way to get up there. Oh, shit. I don't know a way up there. Fuck. Ah, jeez. This seems like a good spot. Smooth. Okay, now from the strip, I should have it. Oh, God. I should have some options. Left turn. Whew. Okay. Should be somewhat smooth sailing from here. But I don't exactly know where the location is. I might have to check my map. Oh, fuck. Oh, fuck. Oh, fuck. There's a turn I can take, I guess. Whoa, that's a turn too early. Uh-oh, come on. Alright, I think this is right into the area where we're gonna meet our last girlfriend. Okay. As long as my car doesn't blow up, I should be good. Woo! Oh my god. Oh, Jesus. This side quest scared the hell out of me. When I remembered that I had to catch up to it. Oh my god. But that went actually pretty smooth. I'd say the quarry went worse. Wow. So there goes all of our heavy machinery side quests. We got the quarry and the trucking missions down. And we can go back and do them if we want, but I ain't going to. Join me next time when I continue with some Wooji-related missions. And, you got the call, see what we do there. Oh, shit, what?
Hello?
Fuck. I accidentally started the mission. Ah, fuck. So I accidentally started the mission, so I have to kill myself. No, don't go inside!
I'm gonna enjoy this.
God damn it, I wanted to go, because like, what I was trying to do was I was trying to go into the save spot to save, and then like, but the problem was because the carpet is red and the mission trigger is red, I couldn't fucking see it.
It's been a complete
that guy just straight up looks like he's closing his eyes at us. Yeah, straight up, he's just closing his eyes at him. But he looks like he's doing it very aggressively. He's just like, I'm woozy, I'm blind, I don't give a shit.
Give him a little something?
No. It's like he's trying to make fun of him without him noticing. But who makes fun of a blind man?
What the?
I love just like the, it's like...
Listen.
I love the bluntness of it. He's like, you can totally see him just looking directly into Carl's eyes while he does it. So you ain't getting a friggin' hole in one, brother. Woozy, don't act like you fucking know what that card says.
47.
Damn. You're bad luck for me, you know?
For five cards, it's like, so his hand is on average above 9.
Oh yeah, the dragon on this got the sunglasses and a white stick.
Wait, hang on. Did they add that onto that as an insult?
Man, look, don't.
Just like this blind motherfucker, like he can tell this. But then again, it also seems like very much a Wooji thing to add that on there. Just like, yeah. Here's my signature.